In this video, we are going to talk about how to use makefiles to generate our code, because the test script is going to call make on your command. So let's see what happens when I call make right now on my homework directory. When I call make, it says nothing to be done for all. So now before we go into make, I think what the homework wants you to do is make a binary called problem one. So all this make just has to auto generate that problem one binary. And so let's see, now I'll generate some code right now, like a test code kind of a thing. So to do that, let's say I want to do a printf in this C file that I wrote. So printf hello, okay, and end line, and then so now even before we start making, how do we want to compile this code? That's what we want to ask ourselves. So this is C, so I'm going to use a compiler called GCC, and I want to make it at the best optimization we have, which is O3. So this is just so that the compiler works hard and make sure our code is compiled at the best optimization that the architecture can offer. So that's that. And then the only file I need is this. And then what do I want my binary called? So that is dash o. And then I make problem one. So this is what how we are going to compile it. And now we want our makefile to do this for us in an automatic way. Okay, so but first let's see if we can compile it in general. So I'm going to see what happens. So I did compile it, and now when I do ls, you see that problem one and it says hello. Another thing I wanted to try out is to see what happens when we do this exe thing. I don't know if it makes a difference or not, or let's see. Now when I do ls, there is this problem 1.exe, and that does the same thing. So I recommend having that .exe because I think your homework spec mentions it. So that is that. And now we want to make a way where these like this binary can be created from your make file, because right now when I do make, it just says nothing to make. So let's see, let's open this and check it out. So I wanted to use GCC, and I think Tim mentioned this CC and CXX here, but at least I don't see where he has defined that. So what I'm going to do is, firstly, I'm working with C, so you're free to change this as you want. We don't care as long as the required binaries are generated. So I'm going to do that now. I'm not working with C++, so I'm removing this firstly. And then I didn't see any GCC. So this is where he expects his compiler to be there. So this is that compiler mentioning command. So GCC is what I'm going to use. And then what I'm going to do is, so the way this works is you make all, and that gives you a directory, sorry, a target to make, and my target is problem one. And in problem one, what you do is you mention that problem one here, and the only dependency I have is problem one dash new, I think, dot c. And then I don't want to use this, and I'm just going to do dash o problem one dot exe. These flags are fine. Let's see what happens. I don't know. Make, so it still says nothing to be done. So is it problem one dot underscore new dot c? Okay, so let me think. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to make this like I make my makefiles usually. So to do that, I'm going to reference this other makefile which I have from my another project. But let me see, I'm going to open my lab computer and use that. I'm going to pause this video for now because I'm going to try to figure this out. Okay, so I think I figured it out. So what I did basically was, the reason it wasn't generating was because there was already this file problem1.exe. But anyway, what I'm doing now is this. The only target I have is problem 1, and then in problem 1 the only dependency I have in problem 1 is this file, and then I'm just giving this direct command where GCC is the compiler I'm using, then -o3 is the performance optimization, the best one, -o3, and then the file I use for it, and then this is saying that this is the output binary we want, problem1.exe. So now here is the thing, like ls, there is nothing. And now when I, let's say I commit all of this to my GitHub repository, then the graders are going to pull it back in their local repository, and then their script will basically call make, okay, and make will generate your binary for you. So if you see, it wasn't there before, and now problem1.exe is there. And now when I do make clean ls, that repository is gone. So when I do make, it comes. If I do make again, it still keeps running it, but ideally it should have understood that the binary is already there and not make it, but that's okay. This file will essentially work for you. And imagine you had another problem called problem 2. Then what you do is basically problem 2, and then you make problem 2 here and colon, and then you the same thing again, type it all over again. So I'm going to copy paste, control insert. I'm just going to do this so that you can see what kind of errors you can get. So this one uses problem 2 new and problem 2, okay. And now suppose this is not even there, there is no problem 2 underscore new, and I call make, then the makefile, firstly there is a separator problem. So makefiles are very picky about the tab spaces. So that's, if you see my, this GCC is not in red, so that's a problem. How it has to be is this tab, okay. And now I escape with, after saving, and now I do make, and it says there is no problem 2. So obviously, because I never made it. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you another command which is very useful in Linux. So what I'm going to do is, I have problem 1 underscore new, so I'm going to copy it to a new file. So this cp is copy, and now I'm just going to call it new.c. So now let's see if that works. So yeah, now when you see, it still didn't quite work. I have made a mistake because there should have been problem2.exe somewhere. So let's see why that happened. So that happened because I did not change this. That's a problem here. And make. And now when I do ls, I can see there are two, and this one right now it's the same thing, hello, but if I go in my problem 2 underscore new, then if I say, I call it by, and I do a make again. So this is the nice thing. Now I can just do make again, and now when I do problem 2, I see by. So once you make this make file, you can just make changes and you have to not worry about again compiling at all. And while submitting, you should do a make clean, because right now it's fine, but later on these binaries can get big and we don't want them on the GitHub. So that's why you do a make clean, and then when you do ls, there's nothing, and then we are going to pull it in our repositories. and when we are going to do make, and then we'll see our binaries and then we'll test them. So that's what is all for make files. You can, you're free to use this one. Where is the make file? So vim make file. So you can just change these three, how many lines? 5 lines, and you can, for you actually, I think there's only one problem, so just that one line and you'll be fine. So the other thing I wanted to show you was more of mobile xterm. So I'm here, I think I need to refresh this. So this test, so if you don't like this vim command, like the vim interface, then what you can do is, especially for like big codes, you can open it with the default text editor they have, or you can also open it with Notepad++, like open with Notepad++. So this is the Notepad++. Also, a clarification about the previous video with GitHub, when I was talking about Vim, I kept on saying click. By that I meant actually type. Like when I said click insert, I meant type insert. So that's all. I think this should be enough information for you to do your homework. And as always, let us know if you face any difficulties.